The faction rally has started, but what faction should you choose? In this video, I'll show you what you can get from ranking up with each faction, and we'll give you advices about which one you should choose based on the weapons they have. Here's what Dead Orbit has to offer. The shaders looks pretty good. First one I see that gives you a dark gray outfit like this. First gun is 3 Graves. This is a high impact pulse rifle, so it shoots pretty slowly but hits harder. I don't think this is a must have, but if you ever get it, I would go with Flared Magwell to get a big boost to the reload speed and that small stability boost. Next, Dire Promise is a hand cannon with some nice perks. This one can be pretty good in PvE since triple tap paired with appended mag gives you the possibility to shoot up to 19 bullets if they're all precision hits. Good weapon here. Next, the sidearm. Nothing impressive here, I would personally just dismantle it if it ever drops. I'm not a fan of sidearms except the ones with a burst firing mode like the Last Hope. I'd pass on this one. Lastly, the Gravity Slingshot Shotgun looks like a good PvP shotgun. Lot of impact and you can get a good amount of range too. If it drops for you, I would give it a shot in PvP. Not talking too much about PvE here, because I pretty much never use shotguns there. I like full auto shotguns, but other than that, I prefer using a sword in close combat. That's it for Dead Orbit. I would say that the only gun worth getting from them would be the Dire Promise hand cannon. Other than this gun, nothing impressive in my opinion. It all depends on your playstyle, but really, I think there's better options with the other factions. Now let's go visit FWC. Shaders are pretty average. It might be because of my current armor set, but yeah, I'm not a big fan. The first weapon here is the True Prophecy hand cannon. This gun is among the best you can get here. It is a super high impact hand cannon, with a lot of range and a very good magazine size of 11. The last perk is really good too. Timed Payload. Projectiles attached to enemies explode after a short delay. It's really similar to explosive payload, but instead of dealing that explosive damage right when the bullet lands, it will after a split second. I was able to one-shot kill cabals with headshots. It's probably my favorite PvE hand cannon now. Next up, the Number Auto Rifle. Pretty similar to the Uriel's Gift or Persecutor. If you don't have one of these, I would definitely try to get this one. I'd go with ricochet rounds to get a boost to range, stability, and reload speed, even if it lowers your mag size. Last perk is pretty good too, especially in PvE. In PvP, I tend to reload every time I can, to make sure I have as many bullets in the mag as possible when entering a gunfight. So I don't think this perk would be super useful, at least for me. Next gun is the Scout Rifle. This gun is an amazing Mito multi-tool alternative. Perfect gun for PvP. It has super good handling, and you move faster when it is equipped. A bit less range than the Mita, but still very good. Same stability from what I can tell, same impact, and slower reload speed, but still reloads pretty quickly. It has 15 rounds in a mag compared to 16 with the Mita, but one bullet isn't that big of a deal. What makes the Mita multi-tool so dominant, in my opinion, is the high caliber rounds perk, which makes the opponent flinch way more than if you would not have this perk. This FWC Scout Rifle has high caliber rounds too. You should definitely keep this one in your vault or somewhere close in case you want to feel like you're using the Mita, but you want to use another exotic. Last weapon here, we have the Eye of Foresight Sniper Rifle. Haven't tried it yet, but nothing too impressive here. Probably the only boring weapon they have. As you can tell, pretty much all weapons are worth it with FWC. The only gun I would dismantle right away is the sniper. Other than that, I would keep them all. Finally, New Monarchy. Shaders looks kinda cool, but I'm not a big fan of the red and gold combination. First weapon we got is the Restoration 8. This is an auto rifle in the same spot as the Martyrs make. Personally, I like this archetype. Fires faster than the Prosecutor but does less damage per bullets. It has a huge magazine of 47. Also has quick draw, which allows you to draw your weapon super quickly. Nothing insanely good here, but I would give it a try. Next up, the Song of Justice 6. I like this kind of scout rifle. high impact, slow rate of fire. You better land those precision shots, or else you might end up doing pretty bad, especially in PvP. I'd say you might want to give it a try, but not everyone likes this type of gun. Next, the Royal Dispensation 2 submachine gun. This one looks interesting. It has great range, stability, and handling for a submachine gun. And again, we have a perk here that will give you an advantage in PvP, which is high caliber rounds again. The Grave Robber perk is kind of a waste in my opinion. It might proc a few times during a match, but it will probably never change anything to your game. But just because it has high caliber rounds, I will definitely keep this weapon if you get it to drop. Finally, the Unification 7 shotgun. It has an insane amount of range, decent amount of impact, high caliber rounds, and full auto, which makes it a solid choice for both PvP and PvE. I would keep this one for sure. This will probably become my go-to shotgun, but like I said earlier, I'm not a big shotgun fan. Maybe this one will make me change my mind. Again, keep this gun if you get it. Nothing groundbreaking with New Monarchy, but I would say that I would try to get the submachine gun and shotgun for sure. The rest is okay, but I don't think you should be sad if you cannot get them. If you ask me, FWC has the best weapons between the three factions. That is why I will go with them, and I think you should too. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, leaving a like would be greatly appreciated. You can also subscribe for more Destiny 2 content. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.